Oh, sorry. It turns out that is plugged in. It's clipping a bit. Let me just turn the gain down. Right. Can you hear me now? I have no idea what the levels are like. I have no idea what the lag is like. So please do let me know. Seems fine. Oh bloody hell. Who'd have thunk it? The webcam's been having a field day as well. It's hugely overexposed. So I've had to basically turn off all the automatic gain and automatic colour balance and white balance and just sort of manually set it, which I don't like in the slightest. It's a bloody expensive webcam as well. I'm really annoyed with that. Well, we'll see how we go. If I do... So, this all worked fine when I set it up this morning, and as soon as I hit go live, it just went poop. I had to reinstall OBS sat here, because the instructions to install OBS on OBS's website are bollocks, and it installs it in a particular way that doesn't work very well, put it that way. Right, so you've got a view. I don't know if you're seeing that in the webcam. So this is the webcam, and then I've got my phone here, which is giving you the other view. See how this goes. Right, I need to grab my gloves. Yeah, exactly. I need to grab my gloves. I'll grab the smoker. And we'll see what happens. I have, if all being well, if I've set this up right, which I think I have, yeah, desktop audio is muted. There's a voice call in Discord. Discord, where if you want to join that, you're more than welcome to, and your voice won't come out on stream, all being well. And it's muted, so or if someone comes in asking questions and I'm not seeing chat, you know, tell them do Discord and feel free to jump in that and ask or give me a shout. Dickitin, hello. Right, let me go and get the smoker and my gloves. One sec. I've got most of my stuff. I'm going to end up dropping things on this table where this microphone is, so I'm very sorry, it's going to peak every now and then when I forget that it's sat on there. Bees, hi Mike! Welcome to the disaster stream where I set everything up and then as soon as I put my suit on and got to this end of the garden, everything broke. I didn't even bring my smoker. Yeah, the installation instructions for OBS on OBS's website tells you to do it a particular way that is not compatible with Twitch. It's absolutely unreal how dumb that is. It's so stupid. Right, my face. Which scene are you on? You're on that one. Do you want to watch the bees or do you want to watch me light my face on fire? There you go. Swap over. Right, so smoker, some cardboard I rolled up this morning. It's going to be an absolute pain in the dick to light. So, when I'm facing the other way, can you still hear me? Or is this mic being very directional? They haven't looked at their own website since 2014. Right. COVID hit hard 7 years before it even hit. I must say, I normally use a bit of firelighter fluid to get this going. Probably should. This is just a ball of cardboard that I just rolled up. I used to use Amazon packaging back when I used Amazon. Oh, I can hear a grasshopper. Yeah, just immediately smothered it like a fucking idiot. Oh, it's not too bad. Well, when we get going, maybe it'll be a bit better, but so far, this isn't a masterclass in how to stream. I can't get that done. Can't get it in the hole. What I might have to do, actually, if the smoker out here. Mike is fine, stream's a bit laggy, yeah. What I'll have to do for next time, I can't do it now, but is I'll have to set up my spare router as a bridge. So I mean, I'm only, what, 25 yards, 20 metres, something like that, from my router. But my router's up against the wall. So the wall is between me and the antennas here, which is a bit annoying. If I wasn't using my phone for the video, I would just use 5G, to be honest. I'm a bit worried of overloading the phone. Ooh, there's a drone. Here we go. Come here. Come here, you dopey bee. Which scene are you on? Not that one. Yeah, I can't actually see my laptop from here, so hopefully that's showing. This is a drone, so that's a male bee. If I am holding this in frame and it is in focus, you should be able to see, hopefully, if he turns towards the camera. Well, the Apica. He's got absolutely massive eyes that meet in the middle, almost just like one big fuck off eye. Oh yeah, it's not behaving. They don't have a sting. Male bees don't have a sting. They just have a massive cock. It is massive as well. It's like 2 or 3 millimeters long, which for their body size is humongous. One day I'll become a bee. Yeah, so they have massive eyes because when they mate with the queen, they do it in the air whilst they're flying. They don't land. So he needs big eyes to be able to latch on, find the queen, latch on to her at the right angle to do the deed. And then when he ejaculates, he dies. And then she'll go on and mate with another 10, 12, 15 other males all in the same flight, and then more often than not that'll be enough. She'll then go back to the hive, fatten herself up, and then lay eggs for the next 5 years without needing a top up. Well, she'll never have a top up later in her life anyway. She'll just eventually run out of sperm that she keeps alive for five, six years, which is quite impressive. And she can choose whether she fertilises an egg when she lays it. And if she fertilises it, it will be a female bee. And if it's unfertilised, it will be a male bee. What a slut. Oh, right. Sounds like a good Friday night out. And she'll only be about a week old at that point as well. Maybe not even a week from after pupation, so after she turns from a grub into a bee. It's about a month she'll be a grub for. Because I've still got my earbuds in, I can't hear very good, which is going to be a problem if the bees get angry, because I won't be able to hear that they're getting angry. Well, that's the worst that could happen. Right, smoke, here we go. Let's change scene. Hopefully it's not too laggy. I presume it is. I presume it's shit. But I need to do an inspection anyway, so I might as well leave everything running. And I am... Yeah, I am recording as well, so I can just put this up on my YouTube. And that won't have all the lag and stuff on it, obviously. So far, they're behaving. They're not bothered about me sat here at all. I've been here for about an hour now. Probably a bit longer, actually. They are quite chill, these bees. I've had bees that have not been that chill before. Right. Can I move the mic? Move the mic right. I don't want to rock DJ. Just put you down there. See if that's any good. Should I change scene? Really lagging now, is it? Yeah, sorry it's laggy. I'll have to do something better for next time. I'm just going to plod on, but I appreciate if it's not watchable, then just, you know, go and do something better with your life. So, if you can hear me, the smoke does two things. well, we use it for one purpose, but it does two things. So the thing we use it for is to basically calm the bees down. Now it works in two different ways. So firstly, they think, crudely, they think the forest is on fire and they're going to have to bugger off and leave home because it's, you know, it's smoke. So it puts them into a mode where they're going to have to leave home, possibly. So they all go into the hive, onto the comb, and basically fill their stomachs up with nectar. Because they think they're going to have to abandon it all, so they might as well, you know, have a full belly. So that means they're quite distracted. They're also getting a little bit drunk on sugar, and so on. And the other thing it does is because they've got a very good... Well, they rely on smell for most things. Smoke has a strong smell. So if one of the bees gets angry and decides to mark me with a pheromone, with a smell, the attack pheromone specifically, then it would put all the others into a frenzy and they'd come and attack me. But if they can't smell that because all they can smell is smoke, then, you know, that one bee gets angry, but then the other 80,000 don't, which is quite handy, obviously. And that pheromone, if you ever smell it, it is lovely. It smells like ripe bananas, or don't know if you get it in other countries, but there's a candy confectionery called Pear Drops, and it smells exactly like that. It's a really, really nice smell. I don't quite trust this smoker at the moment. So you can actually hear me just about there. Oh, that wasn't that way to do it. Why did I do that before? It's rough. Oh, I haven't got my pipe tool. Hang on, one sec. Seems I've put my hive tool in a super secret safe space. Do I have a spare? I can see one. Not my favourite one, but it'll do. It'll do, Pig, it'll do. Hello, yes, I know you're checking me out. You've not seen me for a while, have you, girls? Okay, absolute retard animals. Loads of them are drowned in the feeder because they're absolute morons. Sticky. Very sticky. Oh. Yes, don't even see that, but this was all full of sugar syrup for June, because June, there aren't many flowers out. We call it the June gap. So you've had all the spring flowers, they start building up the colony, getting lots and lots of bees, and then there's fuck all flowers out in June, so they starve. So we give them a bit of food in June. So far, what I might do, see if I can get you a better view. I know, you're checking me out. Don't know how good the resolution is when you can see them doing that. Sort of flying around my face, trying to figure out who I am, whether I'm a threat. Hold is quite good. Oh, I just realised that's now on the cut's going to be sideways on ABS, isn't it? So I have to do it like that. Exactly. Okay. So be checking out. Hey, Alyssa! Sorry it's laggy and everything's shit, it all broke as soon as I pressed live. I had to reinstall OBS and oh god, doing that 2 meters away from 80,000 bees was a bit spicy. In fact, no, I say that, they were perfectly fine actually. So yeah, it's good, it's laggy as shit, maybe not watchable, but I am recording it as well, so I'll be able to put it on YouTube without the lag if you want some background watching in the week or whatever. So, this looks good. This looks like it's all full of honey. Which is a problem because I don't think I've got another box to put on top. This is. Oh wow, look at this. Holy shitballs. Oh, it's all caps and everything. So all of this in here, see the hexagon honeycomb, inside that, this weighs a ton by the way, that's so I have to rest it, it doesn't break. And they've capped it, which means they've dehydrated the nectar. Oh, okay, hang on, I need smoke. One of them's getting a bit angry because of where I'm stood. It's you. I know it's you. Oi, sod off. She's still having a bit of a go. But anyway, so when it's been dehydrated, so it's below, I forget what the number is. Anyway, there's a particular percentage water content, it's got to be below so it won't ferment. They cap it, so they put these wax caps. If I scrape along that, you'll see the honey inside. And that is fucking delicious. There's no other words about it. It is absolutely delicious. It's not like anything you buy in the shops, unless you buy the jars that are, you know, like 12 quid for half a pound. Yes, we still measure honey in pounds in the UK. Pounds weight. One of the very few things that you're still allowed to sell in imperial units. Alcohol being one. Honey being another. I need a bucket for this wax, hang on. That one angry guard bee just followed me all the way down the garden there. That's not ideal. On a good mission to getting a squish, yes you are. So is your mum. So that's one of the brutal things about beekeeping. If you get angry bees, because they're all from the same mother, well, you know, they have the same genetics for you know, years. So the way you deal with it is you kill the queen. They'll then make a new queen, which will have the genetics, still, the angry genetics, but then she'll go and mate with males from elsewhere, and they won't mate with their own hive. So you will get 50% new genetics. And the hope is then that that male came from a karma colony. So then the new babies will be a bit calmer. And if they're not, you rinse and repeat. A little bit of plain God, really. But honeybees are one of the few things that won't, or they, so I've read at least, won't exist without humans. They don't do well in the wild at all. As we've heard a lot of recently with Asian hornets and such. So I'm going to take this box off. There is, they fill it from the inside out. So, oh yeah, here we go. So that's cats, but on the edge here it's not quite cats yet. So it's, they're still drying it off. And then on the back side, none of this is cats. So that's all still nectar in there. That's not honey yet. So, I set my table up because this is going to weigh a ton. Sticky. Some bees like gluing, you know, some colonies, should I say, glue everything together with stuff called propolis, which is tree sap. And some colonies don't. And some are obviously, you know, in between. And this seems to be a very sticky colony. You can see the propolis, it's all this sort of brown stuff. It's a bit, it's not hot today, so it's sort of flaking off. But it's all that stuff. And that stuff, he says, throwing it on the floor, is worth a fortune in money. Absolute fortune. So I'm going to lift this up, I'll show you the underside quickly, and I'll have to put it down because it's going to weigh a ton. Yeah, it does. Jesus. There's the bottom. What I should have done is put it on the roof. On top of that, and then it keeps it dark in there so the bees that are in there don't get agitated. Right, look at all this, holy shit, this all looks like it's full of honey as well. This side's not capped, that side is, yeah, this box is well and truly full. I didn't do it. I'll stand around. Quick look at chat. They're getting a bit closer. Eugenics, yeah. So what this is telling me, just to sort of say why I'm doing this, is that these girls are running out of, well, they've run out of space to put honey. So I need to put another box on this. Because as soon as they start running out of space, they'll want to swarm. Because they've not got enough space in their home. So they have to split into two. And half of them go and find a new home. And that's how they reproduce at the colony level. You know, rather than the individual individual level. So I'm just clearing all this off, this brace comb, just to make it easier to put back together and easier for next time to take it apart. Being as careful as I can not to slice a bee in half when I do it. Unfortunately, there will be casualties. But I'm doing my best. It's quite hard doing that because the wax is fairly firm, so you sort of judders across it. So you can't go slow because it'll just jump like that. Okay, so I don't need to take a frame out here, but just to show you. I'm used to this hive to water. I don't know where my other one went. So that's all completely full as well. Oh, and I've just ripped a bit of brace comb off. So brace comb is where they build honeycomb that's not on the frame. It's in some other direction that typically we don't want it. So if I actually take the frame out that it was braced against, it's a bit more obvious what they did. And it's because the frames were slightly too far apart. I'd given them a little bit too much space. So they built that brace there to hold them together, just in case they get, I don't know, a fucking earthquake or something and think that the whole thing's going to flop about in the breeze. I have no idea. Because the bees are big enough that they can walk across the gap, they can just reach over. Right. Now, so that's two, these are called supers, these small boxes are called supers, and the only thing that goes in them is honey. And the way we ensure that happens is by making sure that the queen can't get in here. If the queen can't get in here, then neither can eggs, and if eggs can't get in here, then there won't be any brood, there won't be any larva, they won't put any pollen or bee bread, which is like a mix of pollen and honey. So, because there's no brood here, so they'll only put that stuff next to the brood. Pollen is what they use for protein, because honey is just pure carbohydrates, sugar. So it means the only thing that can go up here is a worker. The males can't get up here, the queen can't get up here. So that means only honey goes up here. And that's good for us humans, of course, because we don't want to be eating lots and lots of dead bee mixed in with our honey. Oh, This one's even heavier.
Wow.
That's got to be, I'd say, 30 kilos. Between 25 and 30. It's more towards the 30 though. That's heavy. So the way that we stop the queen getting up here is we have this mesh, this wire mesh here. It's called a queen excluder. And basically the workers can fit through there. It's a very specific gap, but the queen cannot. And the males can't either because they're bigger, but it's not really any particularly good reason for excluding the men. It's just happens because. Oops, sorry. So the odd bee does get squished, unfortunately. Try and avoid it. If you're delicate with your fingers. They'll buzz and vibrate if you're about to squish them, and you can feel that. It's like haptic feedback on your phone when your phone vibrates. And then you can just let go quite quickly, and they're absolutely fine. So queen shouldn't be on this. I will do a quick check. No, just workers. Try and give it a bit of a clean. So, I don't know if it's coming across on the camera, but you might see there's quite a few hovering around my face, particularly around my mouth. That's because they can smell the carbon dioxide. Just like a mosquito does, and to be honest, like most insects. So they know that this big output of carbon dioxide is from a big animal. Big animals are quite often a threat. So these bees that are around my mouth are the guard bees. So the bees go through different roles in the colony. And the second to last thing they do is become a guard, if I'm remembering rightly. And they do exactly that. It's just like a military guard. So something unusual is happening. It's those bees that will go out and check it out. Before they're a guard bee, they'll be what's called a nurse bee. Which, like it sort of says in the name, the nurse goes around feeding the grubs, feeding the queen, cleaning the hive. And the reason they stay in the hive, they don't come out, is, well, two reasons. One, the wings may not be fully developed yet, so they can't fly. But more significant, actually, is that the sting won't have developed yet, or at least not the chemical that's the actual sting, so they can't defend themselves outside the hive. So they will stay in the hive as a nurse and as a cleaner until they've developed enough that they can actually go outside and be useful. And then when they finish being a guard bee, they'll become a forage bee. So they'll be leaving the hive, going out, visiting the flowers, and that's when we see them. And they'll do that until the day they die. Which in the summer, that whole cycle can be as short as 3 weeks. So they don't live very long. In the autumn and winter, the bees that are born September, October time will survive all the way through until March. so they have a really interesting sort of life depending on when they're born. You know, the mortality. They're born in the summer, they won't live very long at all, and they'll die of exhaustion basically. But in winter they can live for quite a long time, and they don't hibernate like many other insects do. So they just huddle together like penguins for all of winter. No, this is badly stuck together. I don't know if you see, but all this brace comb here sticking all of this together means that I'm not going to be able to get these frames out very easily at all, not without really pissing them off. And that's likely to be braced all the way down as well, but we'll give it a go. So I'm hoping to see a bit of brood on here, and I can show you some brood. If I don't rip the frame apart. No, that's coming. That's not. So, the bad weather we've had for weeks now has meant that I've not been able to get in here. So they've had chance to stick everything together, and now this is a problem. Got one then. Okay. Right, being very, very careful not to rub them up against the other frames and squash them. I've broken that frame, that's annoying. Right, is there any brood in here? No. So I wasn't expecting there to be. So there's some honey, you can see it's capped off here. There's honey in there. So they use that for the brood, because it's right next to where the brood would be. Some fresh nectar up on the corner nearest me. See that glistening? It's very dark, this frame needs replacing. I got my torch. Getting all sticky now. Oh, there's the first sting. The first bee that's tried to sting me. That might have been me pushing my finger into her arse, to be fair. So she might not have had a choice in that. Very wary about that frame. Yeah, they're behaving actually. Right, let's have a quick look at chat. Hi, Sarah. What I'm learning is that it is possible to do this stream, but there obviously needs some tweaks. But it is possible. You see them running away from the smoke? And what you probably can't see is they're all running to try and find some honey to eat. Right. The reason I did that is so that they're not on the top here. so I can run my tool along. And hopefully not kill as many. So why do we need to do this? Is a good question. If you might be wondering, you know, what if I just leave them alone? Well, the problem is if I leave them alone, disease will get them and they'll die of disease. So it's the lesser of evils. As long as I'm careful, you know, I'm hitting a few here, but they are just, quite a few of them are just bouncing off, which is good. It's just when it slips like that can be a bit of a problem. So yeah, if I wasn't doing this inspection, if I just leave that, just left them to it, and you know, went out over it, they'd be got with either American or English foul brood, European foul brood, should I say, varroa, which is a parasite, which is very prolific. These will have varroa. It's just a case of managing it. And of course, you know, same would be said for if I just, you know, move them to the forest, into nature, they just wouldn't survive. Not in the UK. There's some parts of like Africa where wild bees can survive, honeybees, but certainly not around here. And considering how much pollinating they do and how much good they do for us, it's not really an option to not have them. So yeah, it's sad when you see the old one get smashed, but it'd be nature. Okay, so we've got some grubs in here. They're not very many. Queen might be getting old. By saying that, I mean, this is a bloody big colony. Oh, and I'm double boxed as well. I forgot there's a second box under here. Let's see if I can get you a picture of some doing that. So, where can I stand? I don't want to stand in the front because that'd piss them off. No, that's all just bee bread, it's not grubs. Okay, well that makes a bit more sense. Do you mind? See how it's stinging me? Because the stinger's got a barb on it, she can't get off. I'm going to let her try and get off, I'm not going to brush her off. So if I do that, she'll probably have a hemorrhage and die. If she can get herself off without, not like that, without turning her insides inside out, she will survive. She'll not be able to sting again, she won't have a stinger, but she will survive if she can get off without ripping her guts out. And just help her slightly. Yeah, she got off, actually. But she kept a sting as well. It probably came detached inside, so it's no good, but she should hopefully survive. This one, on the other hand, I don't know if you can see the. Oh, she's just flown off. It was trailing her guts out behind it. Right, let me just smoke my gloves, because they're clearly smelling the stings on the. So they're stinging the same bit each time. So, you know, they're just flying around and then they smell the sting from a previous bee and go, oh, right, we're doing that, are we? Psh! very hive mind. Oh, I really want to just take this box off. It is so far gone. So badly stuck together. Thing is, I bet the one underneath it's even worse. And grubs. So the reason I'm looking for grubs now is one, to make sure we've got a queen. I'd like to see eggs, because that means we've had a queen within the last three days. So I know that the colony is healthy. Well, that's one indicator at least towards a healthy colony. To see grubs, I know there's been a queen in here within the last couple of weeks. These girls are very, very sticky. And then I'm looking for the queen, because if I see the queen but don't see eggs, then, you know, I know at least they've got a queen. But also, I need to make sure that if I do see her, I don't drop her on the floor, because that would be bad. We can make another one, but it takes weeks, and they'll be very angry in the process. Nothing interesting up here. What I'd like to do in this box just needs replacing, really. To do is take some frames that got brood on them, which is going to be in the box underneath. You can still see me on that camera. Put them in here and then split it into two colonies. Problem is, this box, don't know if it's obvious on the other camera, but this box is 1.5 deep, so you can see that this frame is bigger than this box, so I can't easily mix and match between the two to split, because these frames won't fit in there when I split them out. Which is a problem. Okay, that's full of pollen. Don't know if you can see that on there. See all the different colours of pollen from all the different plants. Put your stinger away. I know you're thinking about it, don't. Don't know if you've ever seen a wasp on a window, that you can see the stinger coming out when they're trying to sting a window, which is quite funny. You can see the bees do that as well. It's not quite as obvious, because it's a smaller. These gloves are getting very sticky. Yeah, they're getting a bit pissed off. I don't know if you can hear the sound has changed. They are getting a lot more. Yeah, that one just landed in and straight away stung. There's a male at the bottom of there. You can see he's a bit chunkier. Look. Stop it. Now these gloves are marked. Let me just go and wash these off a little bit. I don't think I'm going to get into this bottom box. They're not in a good mood, are they? Yeah. I don't know how well it's coming across on the camera, but the sound is... This sounds angry. Very different to what they were before, and they weren't bothered. Well, we've got half of it done. I know that they need some boxes on top, so I can go make one of those up and then put that on probably tomorrow. I won't do it this evening if they're grumpy, because I want to get my shorts on. Yeah, see, look, they're coming straight back up again. It's because they're overcrowded in this box. Well, go back down. If you don't go back down, you're going to get squashed when I put you all back together. What we can do is we can look at this other box, which I'm hoping... Jesus Christ! So put this on at an angle and then rotate it, because then that pushes the bees off rather than dropping it on top and just squashing them. I'm hoping there's another colony in that polystyrene box behind me. I did a bit of an emergency... Oh. Who spotted that? Oh, that's so heavy! This one's not as heavy, but still at least 20 kilos. Yikes. Look at the roof. Oh, sorry. Just checking for any blokes. Because if I put this on with blokes, they won't be able to get back down. I think we're good. Come on, by the way. And don't worry about those ones trapped on top, because they can get out of here. guess, so I'm hoping there's a colony in here, but I'm not hopeful. That sentence makes no sense. I'm not confident. So let's move you around. I do want a drink as well, it will stop flying in front of my face. I have to go inside because I can't push the water bottle up against my face because they'll just immediately sting me through the mesh. Right, so how can I do this? Oh. Don't sting my foe, you dopey creature. They see the shiny black lens of the phone, and they absolutely hate that. I hate black, basically. Presumably because bears. But I don't actually know. They sound absolutely pissed off, do they? Hey, soup! Yeah, they went from pretty decent to pretty pissed off quite quick. Which isn't not it's not atypical. Can I move the put the mic there? Right there. And I'm going to stand here in front of this hive, which is going to really piss them off. But that was reasonably in frame. So, yes, wow, about the 20th time trying to finish this sentence. There's either a colony in here, or these bees going in and out are just robbing it. Feels very light, so I don't think there's anything in here. No, there's not. Oh, maybe. Not very many in there, though. So this is a slightly different style of queen excluder. So you can see a couple there. So just the same thing, just different design. Bit of stamped metal. This doesn't look like a colony. For how long they've been in here, I don't know. Don't know, that's a lot of bees. There is a colony in them. I've got a problem because I've not got... So if I want to split that, I need another box and floor. And then if this is actually a colony, this needs going into a full size. This is called a nucleus. So this needs going in as well. Oh, it is. It is a colony. Oh, look at that. Right, we might find a queen here. Right, so how do I know this is a colony? Oh shit, that's... I'm well surprised. I didn't think this had worked. This was a bit of a messy job when I set this up. So on here, you can put this side probably better. But you can see it's capped, like it was with the honey, but can you see how it's like a biscuit colour? Brown biscuit colour? So that's because there's, in this case, there's female worker grubs in here that are pupating into female bees. Worker bees, not queen. If I get you a bit of light, hopefully, if I can see, if I get this close enough, you might see in some of these, getting strobing from this torch angle. Mm-hmm. Is that one first modulated? Oh, it is. Oh, bollocks. But in there, you might see some white, it's curled round grub. See, they're a couple of weeks old. And then when they get old enough, then they spin a little cocoon, just like a butterfly does, a caterpillar, should I say. And then they cap it with wax. And then a little while later, a bee will come out. Stand on stinging these gloves. They really don't like these gloves. I normally wear rubber gloves. These are leather. And they definitely don't like leather. Things that these are more dexterous. You get more control with these. I just realised I'm stood in front of that webcam. So these are all workers, right? See if I can find some male or queen. There's probably not a queen comb on here. Put you to one side for a minute. Don't want to leave it out too long. There's a big bunch of bees here. Makes me wonder if there's a queen in the middle of it. She immediately ran over here. No, okay, so no queen, I don't think. I hope not. Doesn't know she's on the fence. And that's bad because she can't fly. Or at this stage in her life, she can't fly. Okay, so more cat comb. You see what I mean? They've got a bit of honey around the outside, a bit of pollen, the protein. See red pollen in there, it's probably dandelion. White is ivy, I think, if I remember right. Some dark brown, lots of different yellows, there's a green there. I'm not seeing a queen, but there's a male, so that's a drone. See how much bigger he is compared to the other. I know it's hard to tell, and say, oh, this is a drone, look, he's bigger. But when you see them side by side, hopefully it's sort of a bit more obvious how much larger he is, the size of him. And he's off. So I don't actually need to do anything here because I've seen grubs. So that means there is a queen in here because the grubs I put into this hive would have hatched by now. It's really lime green. I don't know if the colour's coming out well on camera, but really lime green. Oh, she's brushing it off into the cell. See her kicking it off? I hope that's coming across on camera, that's really cool. I've not seen her do that before. I'm hoping I see a waggle dance. Yeah, so I'm just looking for a queen now, really, just to show you guys. I haven't seen eggs, but I've not particularly looked, if I'm honest. So she's either on this frame, I would think, or she's dropped into the box. On that side. Is that up? No. If you've seen my picture in Mike's stream, the one that comes up for community pets, the queen is the one on her own in the top corner, and it's quite noticeable how big, how much longer she is. So she's not fat like a male, like a drone, but she's long, and that's so that she can get her whole backside all the way to the bottom of the cell to lay an egg. Oh, and I can see eggs in there. So there's been a queen in here in the last couple of days. Chances are she just ran onto the walls of the box as I was taking all this out. And they do have a bit of space in here, so I'm not actually in any rush to move them out into a full-size box. Lime green. I'm going to have to find out what that's from. What plant gives lime green pollen? It's like, I mean, look at these two. There's a yellow there, which probably not coming out on camera, but it's fluorescent to my eye. And then this lime green is pretty much fluorescent as well. Not quite as much as the yellow, but it's very pretty. So, oh, she's there. Oh, I can see her. See if I can pop you out. Right. Can't activate the flash, unfortunately, because I can't do it with my gloves. But she was. No, oh, she's fucked off. Damn it! Where'd she go? They're quick. The queen's easy to tell because she's fast. But it was definitely a new queen. She was absolutely massive. Down here, they're all walking along here, so I better... If I saw her here, she'll be long gone from there now. Now I've made it bright. Don't know how well this is coming across on camera. I can't see my screen because I've got the sun right behind me. There's still a few guard bees giving me help from the other hive. This hive's absolutely fine. There's a drone. I'll put these frames back in a slightly different order, which I'm not really supposed to do. What a disaster. I'm being really gentle now because I know she's in there and the last thing I want to do is squash her. They would be able to make a new queen, but it would take weeks. And this isn't a very big colony. So that wouldn't be good. Oh, I'm annoyed I can't see her now. Well, she is in there. Well, next time we'll get a queen for you. So I think what'll happen is next time, which there will be, we'll put these into a full size box. I think I do have one in the shed, it's just not made up, so I need to nail it all together. But I'm not too rushing because they've got plenty of space and they've got a lot of space in the super as well in the top. Sorry, didn't mean to bang you. Take the bishop to the priest. So, here we are. Oh, and the sun's coming out now. It's annoying timing. They normally chill out a bit more when the sun comes out. Now they have got plenty of food in there. I am tempted to give them something though. If I've got some. What's that all like? have something. Look at this. Delicious. Oh, the yum yum yum. Who wouldn't want to eat that? So this is called candy pollen. It's pollen mixed with fondant, so sugar. So this feeder, I can explain this to you a bit. Shouldn't really leave that out, that's going to be covered in bees in a minute. So this feeder is a liquid feeder. So you put liquid in there, sugar syrup. And then this is like a little dam with an up and over, so they can crawl down there to the level and sip it, and it gradually decreases and it can go underneath there. So it just minimises the amount that drown, because they are stupid. But if I want to put solid food in there, I can take these dams out. Put that out of the way. Like that. And then put this in this side, and then they can just crawl in. So this hole here, that's it, that's the hive is in there. Then. Right, I need my other hand. Still a few guard bees that are a bit annoyed with me because I've not left and I'm stood right in front. Which doesn't help. This stuff's a bit old, but still seems pretty good. And then on goes the lid to stop everything else getting in. So that's right at the top of the hive so that they can defend it. So others can't come in and rob it because they'd have to get through there, right? Oh, look, bee. Put this on the fence just to, I hope that it warns people that there's bees. I don't really think it does much good. But then no one comes and moans that they get stoned. Right. Switch room where? It's not switch, it's my own taxi. I set everything up this morning and it worked fine, and as soon as I needed to go live, everything broke. I had to reinstall OBS because OBS is instructions on how to install on Linux are wrong. It was just, yeah, a pain in the arse. So, my wax bucket, look at that, that's what I'll turn into candles. That's got a bunch of bees in it because they're robbing all the honey that came out, so I need to leave this out. So I'm going to leave this far enough away from the hive. But this evening when it goes dark, I can come and get it, and all the bees will have flown back for bed, and I can come and grab it without getting too close to the hive this evening, so I don't need to put a suit on or anything. And then I can put the lid on and there won't be any bees stuck in there. That's the plan. Right, well, we're done. There's still a few really not happy with me. They'd normally chill out for now. I say that they were pretty angry though. do better than that. There we go. Right, while I'm cleaning up then, I'll leave you with that view. Where's that view? Bees, you start crossing the screen. Bees alleyways, hey ya! How you doing, Ollie? Stream's laggy and shit and buggered and broken and all the things. But good to see you. Right. I only went through one roll of cardboard today. Right. Yeah. I'm going to start packing up. I'll leave the cameras and the microphone on and everything. I'm going to do a bit of weeding while I've got my suit on, because would you use it? Give you a better angle on here. I really can't see my laptop screen in because the sun's come out. I can see chat. I'm the queen, yeah. I've hacked it, don't tell Mork, right? Can I show you? I'm in light mode. OBS and everything's in light mode. I just can't see the screen otherwise. It pains me. Right, my other pixel bud's just fallen out of my ear anyway, so I can't put that back in with gloves on and a veil. Why have you got angry again? You chilled out, girls. Sort those shit out. Sun's come out, you got shitloads of honey. Well, the good news is, the new watch, because I'm still here, so I'm going to curse it, I've not been stung once. Because, well, they've stung my gloves, but it's not got through. But here, I've only got a t-shirt on under this. This thing easily goes through this. As I found out many a time. Nettles and ivy. Blah. Stop looking at my arse, chat. Should really do this on a day when they're not quite so mad at me. Probably get some more smoke. Smoke. My phone is going to be absolutely covered in bee poo. I never stop looking. Gotta be careful doing that, that I don't burn a hole in my veil. That would be a bad thing. This is all dying, which is good. feel like a YouTuber post 10 doing all this. Well, it's not a beaver dam, I guess. It's a good firewood. God, I've wanted to dig this out for years. I never did it because it would have been a pain in the ass for the bees. And now it's all actually dead. I didn't think it was dead. Oh. Oh, it's brilliant. And it's gone. Just keep on top of this wretched ivy. Should go. A mess over there for another day. I don't think they like my phone there because that's on their flight path. Yeah, I'm going to move my phone. Close as I'm going to get you. Oh, nice. Hey, well, you've had that view all day, haven't you? Let's try this one. I appreciate that's on the piss, but deal with it. Any questions about bees? Beekeeping. Just want to keep my eye on the chat. Hey Nana! How you doing, Nana? You alright? Oh, I'm sniffing now. Hay fever's got me. Finally. Bending over, pulling weeds out because it's making my veil stick to my face. And one of these bees is going to realise in a minute that if she lands on the veil, she can get my skin. My face sting isn't nice. Oh, shit. Sure. It's only a matter of time before I kick the wire. Oh, I don't know if that camera's come back online. I can't see my screen very well. I can see chat. There's chat's light mode. So many weeds. Don't do it. I know you're thinking about it, girl. Well, this colony has been very well behaved. The other one, not so much. But I did piss off the other one a lot more. So, that'd be fair. Oh, well, damn fucked. Doesn't really look any different. Cleaned a bit of it out. That big stump has gone, that's been there since I moved in, which is 13 years now. And I have a big pile of shit here to deal with. Oh, no, that's the rotten one. That's what these were on before. I put a video in mics. I'm going dangerously close to getting a sting on the chin here. Yeah, I put a video in big mics and showing that they made like a big colony underneath one of the hives. And that's what it was on. Right, we're getting this. Can get this, sir. Please look at it. Porridge. It's absolutely mad for it. Is there any real in already? See one not that you'll meet. Okay, that could be. That would be in there. A load more in here. In fact, you can see these ones are packed. There's some stuff out of the way. Where you can see. I've just realised the microphone's over there. So used to talking at my phone, I forgot the mic was here, sorry about that. Right, I'm going to call it a day there, chaps. Thank you very much. Hopefully I can get the creases ironed out. Sorry, I'm probably all snotty and minging. These bees aren't leaving me alone because they can smell all the juices and hay fever reaction that's just suddenly hit. Oh, that's gross, sorry. But yes, I'll try and get all the creases ironed out for next time. Right, ta-ta. See if I can figure out how to close the stream with these gloves on, because I sure as hell ain't taking these off yet. Hi, Nanny! Hi, Nanny!